Hello. As you can see, I'm in a better quality picture, but it's more zoomed in on my face and I'm further away from the camera. I've had quite a struggle trying to focus this on myself because I'm not used to this lens and it's smaller and I've got really small arms, so I can't reach. I've tried to make a video about 6 times now, but every time I've gone to edit it, it's terrible. So, you know, hopefully this one won't be, but I'm guessing it will be. This is Ellen's stupid thoughts. Just now I was brushing my teeth and as I was brushing them, I was thinking, I'm literally brushing my teeth with my own spit. I'm using my own saliva to brush my teeth. But yeah, you get fresh water and you get toothpaste. If you think about it, you're going swish, swish, swish around your mouth and you're actually washing the saliva around your mouth, only making it smell mintier. Something I've been thinking about recently quite a lot is death. I don't know, I'm kind of scared of death, but I'm more scared of what happens to me afterwards. Do I just become a dead carcass in the ground, just rotting away, and then like in 1,000 years they're gonna bury me up and be like, oh look, an Ellen skeleton. Skeleton. Or do we regenerate and go into a different body? So if I die today, will I become a newborn baby tomorrow? Or have I lived before and this is like really my like 700th life? Also another thing I've been thinking, if nothing does happen after life, I think what's the point? Like what's the point of doing anything? We've got this one life. Oh, it sounds so cheesy. So many people say you've got one life, do what you want with it. You've got one life. You've only got one chance of being you in this body. I kind of actually want to die like on an operating table for a couple of minutes, just to see what it feels like. For the first 2 years of your life, you're a baby and don't do anything other than sit there and cry. After that, for the next like 15 years of your life, you're expected to be in education. The first 18 years of your life is pretty much education. And then after you're 18, you're considered an adult and expect to go get a job. And you're supposed to be able to live by yourself and do all this stuff. And that scares me as well, being able to live by myself and like financially supporting myself, but I don't think I will be able to. And then you have to work up to the age of 60, 65, and then you have to retire. And the retirement time you get is probably a good 20 years, but you don't get to do much because you don't have the energy where you're old, hence why you've retired, unless you're a granny on steroids. In my opinion, I think if you want to do it, go bloody jump off that bridge. I want to road trip around America, so once I can learn to drive and I'm old enough and have money and some friends who also want to do it, I will happily go drive around America. One day, I'm guessing this summer, once Summer in the City is announced, I will be buying myself a ticket and I'll be getting on a train to London. Something else I think about a lot is stuff to do with colours, like, do we all see the same colours? Do you see the same red, or is red like a different colour to you? And another weird thing is trying to imagine a colour that you can't even think of. The world's probably gonna flood one day. So what if we all like lived in water? Like, do we have to start practicing? Do we grow fins and gills and we all swim around like we're all like half human, half fish? We'll all be mermaids. Apparently we see everything upside down or something like that. So I'm thinking like, okay, I'm really sitting on the ceiling, but it's not a ceiling, it's a floor. But in my mind, I'm sitting on the ceiling. So I'm gonna go, and to finish this video, I'm just gonna put a little montage-y clip kind of thing, things I've been doing recently, because we just had half term and I filmed a bit of it, so you know, enjoy it and I'll see you another time. Bye! There's a bonfire burning tonight.